Over the past few weeks in year 6 of the education program at VIU, my brain has been bombarded with new information. Today, I'm going to discuss the main things I learned that stood out for me in a significant way in my journal, Speakers and Films, Inquiry Questions, and Pro D. In the first week, I was reassured to see familiar faces from last term, but found it daunting as the program structure was different than anything I had experienced previously, with lots of individual and independent learning. I have grown up with and succeeded in a more traditional model of education, of lectures, note-taking, readings, and essays. However, if I'm going to teach using the new curriculum and a student-centered approach, this new structure provided an experience that I could adapt to use with my future students. On the Wednesday in the first week, the three cohorts took the ferry over to Thetis Island, where we would be engaging with our pods in team-building activities. Thetis provided us with some time to communicate with our pods. Our group took on kayaking and the high ropes course. I also enjoyed the free time opportunities of playing cards with friends and listening to some of the music performed at the coffee house. We were also introduced to the Earth Charter and the Community Action Project, which we would be working on throughout the weeks to come. The learning I experienced had a few important components, the first being the inquiry cycles, in which instead of a traditional classroom model, we were expected to come up with an inquiry question relating to our topic of the week, whether special education, governance, or social justice. We then researched our question and presented our findings to our group members at the end of the week. My first week was special education, and I posed the question, what are the benefits of art therapy, and how can art therapy activities help children with mental and emotional challenges? I watched TED Talk, Art Therapy, A World Beyond Creative Expression by Carol Hamill, and Art as Empowerment, The Virtue of Art Therapy by Anne Lawton. I found strategies of art therapy that could help students with challenges such as ASD, ADHD, anxiety, depression, trauma, and expressing emotions. I created a mind map to demonstrate my findings and my thought process. My second week was governance, and my inquiry question was, in what situations can students appeal school board decisions to the Ministry of Education, and what steps are involved in the student appeal process? I found most of my information on the gov.bc.ca website. It provided clear and straightforward steps, including forms to be filled out and people who could be contacted. I wonder how rare this appeal process is used, as I am sure most principals would want to settle disputes before they move to the school board. My third and last inquiry week was social justice. My question was, how can I encourage parents or guardians in supporting their child's learning? I found a lot of very interesting and useful information, varying from tips such as asking parents what they need, providing materials on ways to help children and youth at home, communicating news of progress, and encouraging a broad understanding of what it means to help, listening, reacting, praising, guiding, monitoring, discussing, and asking questions as opposed to sitting down and actually helping with the content. A strategy I thought was very important, which I will use as a teacher, is focusing on the positive. Middle school teacher Maxine Taylor says, I call or email parents whenever a student does a nice job or has been exceptionally helpful in class. She says the extra effort only takes her a few minutes and does wonders for her relationship with parents. Questions that I asked my pod to consider were, do we know which students come to school without the support of a caring adult? And how are we connecting students with caring adults and positive role models? While all this inquiry was taking place, we are also in the process of our ECAP project. On September 14th, we met with Lisa Frey of Departure Bay Eco School and discussed opportunities to work with the grade 6-7 classes at the school. They had recently done a shoreline cleanup and picked up piles and piles of cigarette butts. The following week, on September 21st, we went in and worked with two grade 6-7 classes on researching a variety of questions such as, what are the effects of cigarette butts on the environment? 2, what is the marine ecosystem in Departure Bay? Each of my pod members worked with a small group of 5 to 6 students and focused on a question. We then brought the research together to create a fact sheet. On September 28th, we had guest speaker Christy Wilson from Stream to Sea come in and talk to the students about the marine biology in Nanaimo and the effects of pollution on the environment, specifically plastic and cigarette butts. Our next steps, we plan to create a sign that we will be placed permanently on Departure Bay Beach by the city of Nanaimo to help stop people from throwing their butts on the ground. Finally, there were also many opportunities where I listened and learned from guest speakers such as Terry Mack from Strong Nations Bookstore. Terry discussed integrating Aboriginal content into our classrooms. I think what most interested me about the talk is when she was talking about banned schools and the misconceptions people have about bans, reserves, and taxes. I never realized that students living on a reserve had to have their band pay for public education if they decided to attend these schools. Then there was Stacy the following week discussing FASD and other challenges. He stressed the importance of realizing as teachers we can make very positive impacts or negative based on one word or action we take in dealing with conflict or intense situations. The final week, watching the film Most Likely to Succeed, some circumstances in this movie made me squirm uncomfortably, such as the teacher on the first day of school trying to force and facilitate a discussion before creating a safe classroom environment or a community. The idea of a teacher choosing a student without their hand up or unwilling to speak makes me anxious. I don't like the idea of putting someone on the spot. Overall, the idea behind the school had a positive message, but there still seemed to be little research supporting this model of education. I'm the type of person that appreciates organization, structure, and clear criteria for an assignment, so I probably wouldn't do very well with this model of education, but doesn't mean other students wouldn't succeed in it. There were many more learning opportunities through ProD workshops which I attended, such as differentiating instruction, planning with different learning needs in mind, and ethics of care. And of course, there will be many more opportunities in the future. In this profession, we are always learning, finding new strategies, keeping up with new technologies, trying to create learning environments, and to help students think creatively and critically. As I finish off my classes and move into practicum, I hope that my learnings will transfer over to my teaching practice.